Hello friends, in this video we will solve LeetCode problem number 827, making a large island. So first we will see the problem statement, then we will see approach for this problem, and at the end we will see code in JavaScript and Java. So the question says that we have given n cross n binary matrix grid which contain values 0 and 1. So we need to find maximum connected ones in the matrix, and there is one condition: at most one time we can change 0 to value 1. So now let's see the example. I have here written 10 and 01, this one. So if we replace 0 with 1, this one, so it will be connected and it will give 1 2 3, so it will give 3, maximum 3 is connected. Again, if we have 1 0 0 and 1, then if we change this 0, then we have this connected 3. So our output is 3, as we can see. So now let's see another example. So here we have given this 0 1, so we will select this one 0 and replace it with 1. Then we have connected this, these are the connected. Why we are not taking this one? Because in the question they mentioned we have 4 directional connected group, means we need to take horizontal connected and vertical connected. So we will not select this one. So now we have connected 1 2 3 4, so now till the answer is 4. So now again we will select other 0 and replace it with 1 and check connected ones. This is connected, this is, so we have again the group of 4. So our max is also 4, so we will not replace the answer. Then again we have 0, then we will check, convert it into the 1 and check the nearest connected ones. So there is no connected, so it is 1, it is smaller than 4, then we will not replace the answer, we will keep the answer as it is 1. The 1 is connected with this one, this one, and this one, so our answer will be 4. So till now we have covered this one and we have answered till 4 right now. So we will check for this 0 now. So we will convert this 0 to 1 and check the connected ones. So this is connected, this is connected, this is connected, this is connected. So our answer will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So our answer is 4, but we now found the connected ones are 5. So we will change the answer to 5. So till now we covered this 0 and we got the max answer is as 5. So we will now check this 0 and replace it with 1. So we will replace and we will see horizontal and vertical, there is 0, so we have no max value. So because it is currently 1, so it is smaller than 5, we will not replace this with the value 5. So now we will check this 0 and replace it with 1 and check connected components for this, 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 and this. So it will return 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it will return 4. But 4 is less than 5, then our answer max will not change. Again, we will take this 0 and replace it with 1. So our connected will be this, 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 and this. So our connected will be like this. So it will give 1 2 3 4 5. So because we have already 5 value, so we will not replace and our answer will be 5. So now let's see how we approach this problem. So what we will do, we will use the color technique and DFS for connected components. So when we will check in the matrix. If we have 1, we will replace it with 2 and increment the counter, and again if we will get 1, we will replace with the counter. So let's take this example and iterate. So we have iterated through this 0, so we will continue iterating till 1. So we got this 1, so we will replace all that connected ones with value 2. Initially we will take value 2. So our matrix will look like 2 0 0 0 0 2 2 0 0 0 0 1, because 1, this is not horizontal connected to this, not connected in vertical to this, because of that reason we are not changing this value. So now we got this for this connected one. So we will check again in the iterating through the matrix if we again get 1 or not. So we will receive here 1, and we will increment this with 1 and it will become 3. So we will replace this with value 3. So our matrix will look like 0 2 0 0 0 2 2 0 0 0 0 3. So we will create one map for storing the key values. Our key will be the IDs and the value will be connected values, means this one connected values, and ID will be this 2. So we have two connected, two counts are 3, and for 3 we have 1 value. So now we will iterate through the matrix and check if we found 0, and we will check its vertical and horizontal values are present in the key. Then we will replace that 0 with 1 and add to the answer and check it is max or not. So it will look like key present plus 1 for replacing 0. So let's iterate through the matrix and see. So we will check for this 0, we have horizontal and vertical connected this. So 2 have value 3, so 3 plus 1 will give 4. Then we will check for this 0, for this 0 we have horizontal and vertical 2, then 2 have value 3 plus 1 equal to 4. For this 0 we will check, and we will check horizontal and vertical, we have 0 only, then data is not, then 0 plus 1 equal to 1. For this 0 we will check horizontal and vertical, it have 2, then its value is 3, and 3 plus 1 will be 4. Again we will check for 0 0 horizontal and vertical, so we have 2 have value key 3 have value 1, so we will write 1 and we will replace this with 1. With 1 we will get 5. Again we will iterate through this, it has 0, then 0 plus 1 equal to 1. Again for this vertical and horizontal, 0, 0 plus 1 equal to 1. Again we have 0, then left horizontal and vertical we will get 2 and 3, so 2 have value key 2 have value 3, and 3 have 1, and it will be 3 plus 1 plus 1 equal to 5. So our answer is already max, it is 5. So our final answer will be 5. So our time complexity will be O of n square, because we are iterating through the array matrix. And space complexity will be O of n square, because we are using the DFS approach, in which we are using the recursion stack, will go up to n square. So now let's see solution in JavaScript. So here I have taken connected group ID, it will represent 2, because we have already 0 and 1 in the matrix, and here we are creating a hash, it will store group ID and the connected count, which we have 1 connected. After that I have declared answer equal to 0, and I had created one function for iterating through the connected components. So here function will have argument grid, indexes and ID. ID is the ID that we have taken this one. Okay, then we are iterating through the left, right, up, down, and we are adding 1 here at the end, because we are converting that particular 0 to 1. So I am iterating through the grid means matrix and checking if it is 1, then I am iterating through that and assigning the connected count to that value and finding the maximum and incrementing the count group ID. Again, here I am iterating through the direction. I have taken direction left, right, up and down, and iterating through the matrix. And here I am checking if it is 0, then I am iterating through the direction and adding to the hash set. And after that, from the hash set, I am checking horizontal and vertical values in the hash map and adding it to the temp variable. I initialize here temp with 1 because we are changing the 0 with 1, because at most we can change 0 to 1. So after that, I am checking the answer as max, and at the end I am returning the answer. Let's run the code. So code is run successfully. Now I will submit the code. Yeah, the code is also accepted. So now let's see solution in Java. So here I take it connected group ID equal to 2, because we have in matrix grid 0 and 1. So I have taken the hash map, key and value will represent group ID and connected count, and variable I have answer equal to 0. So here I am iterating through the grid and checking if it is 1, and I am iterating through that 1 and finding the connected components. And after that, we have count of that. I am assigning to the key value, as group ID is key and value is count, and at I am finding the max value from that and incrementing the group ID. After that, I have given the directions. It will represent left, right, top and down. So again, I am iterating through the grid and checking if it is 0, and I am created a hash map for adding that horizontal and vertical values. After that, I am iterating the four directions. Here I am checking if it is 0, connected one, horizontal and vertical. Then I am continuing, else I am adding into the hash set, because we get two values like 2 and 2 two times. Then in set we will get unique one. Then I am iterating to the set and adding into the temp variable. And here we have defined temp equal to 1, means one value of 0 to 1. At the end, I am taking the max as the answer value and I am returning the answer. And here is the DFS function. For iterating the DFS function, we are checking if it is out of grid or not. If it is out of grid, we are returning 0, or it is not 1. And we are here assigning the grid as the ID. So, and we are checking here, means we are iterating recursively left, right, up and down. And here we can see here is 1. So I am adding that into the answer, because we are converting 0 to the 1. Thank you for watching my video. Please like and subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon so that you are notified for my future videos.